Hi and welcome. A botnet is a network of internet-connected devices which are infected with a piece of software known as bot. After infection, these internet-connected devices operate on the instruction of the owner of this botnet known as bot master. Now, this entire process of botnet is carried out in four phases. In this video, I will explain the architecture of this botnet, its various uses for the hacker, and the countermeasures against botnet. Now let's start. Now this is a cyber criminal or a hacker, or known as bot master or a bot herder, who wants to infect this system so that this system may become part of his botnet. Now this system is connected to the internet. So first of all, this cyber criminal in phase one set up a malicious website which is hosting a malicious software or a bot software. Then this cyber criminal posts a link to this malicious website on the social media, and the user clicks on this link and he is redirected to this malicious website where the bot software gets installed on his system and the system gets infected and become a bot or a zombie. Another method this cyber criminal can use is that he may send a phishing email with this malicious link, and if the user clicks on this link, he is redirected to the same malicious website where his system gets infected. And a third method is that this cyber criminal, now this method, before going to the third method, this method is known as drive-by downloads, where the system is get infected with a malware just by visiting a website. Now the third method which this hacker may use is that he may attach a malicious piece of software with this email, and if the user downloads this attachment, then the system gets infected. Now the second phase is the connection phase, where the system establishes a connection with the command and control server, which is established by this cyber criminal. So cyber criminal establishes a command and control server through which he will later on delivers his command to the infected bots. Now the bot or the infected machines itself connect to this command and control server, and this connection may be carried out periodically, or it may be carried out upon fulfillment or completion of a specific logic, for example on a specific date and time, or a detection of a specific traffic in the target network. Now the third phase is the control phase, where the cyber criminal issues command to the infected bot through this command and control server. So the fourth phase is the multiplication phase, where this entire process is repeated numerous times to infect thousands of machines connected to the internet to become part of botnet. So hacker may set up different or multiple command and control server to control multiple botnet. Now what are the uses of this botnet for the hacker or bot master? Now this bot master may use his botnet to do advertising fraud, where he may use his botnet to click on the ads to generate funds, or he may use this botnet to spam over the internet through the advertising emails, or he may use this botnet to mine bitcoins, or he may also install keylogger software on his botnet computers to get their password or their credit card information. Or he may use his botnet to conduct distributed denial of service attack. And one example of using botnet to conduct distributed denial of service attack was experienced in 2016, where this Mirai malware or Mirai botnet was used to infect multiple IoT devices or Internet of Things devices, so that these devices became part of this botnet, and this botnet was used to target a domain name server system hosted by Dyn. Or he may rent his botnet to other cyber criminal, or he may use his botnet to conduct phishing emails or to send phishing emails all over the internet, or for example sending ransomwares as attachment to these emails. Or he may use his botnet to conduct pooling frauds, where the vote of each system or each infected system in his botnet will be considered a unique. Or he may use this botnet to brute force the passwords. So what are the countermeasures? So we have to use defense in depth, that is various controls in series, so that if any single control get bypassed, then other controls are there to protect against botnet. For example, user needs to update his antivirus definitions, or to patch his browsers or operating system with latest security patches, for example, including the plugins available in a browser. Or user have to enable various default security measures available in the browsers, for example, sandboxing, which basically isolate the browser application from other applications hosted on the same operating system. Or a corporate may educate its users to protect against phishing emails, for example, not to click on any suspicious links. Or the IoT's vendor may have to design their products with security in mind. So this was all from my side. Please stay connected to my channel for similar videos. Thank you.